I'm Senator Jim Honeyford of the 15th Legislative District. Our district includes the Yakima Valley, Klickitat County, Skamania County, and a part of Clark County. I'm speaking to you from the Capitol in Olympia, and this is my latest report from the 2011 legislative session. I want to start by remembering someone who really made an impression on me during her time on this earth, which was cut short last year. That's Blanca Torres, who, among other things, was a co-founder of the bilingual Hispanic newspaper based in the Tri-Cities. I knew Blanca and as a vibrant young woman who was very active in the Hispanic community along with her husband, and her passing will be a great loss for that community. Blanca's untimely passing last August from a brain aneurysm was a huge loss for her husband and two sons. And it was a big loss for the community, as I've mentioned, and really for the whole state. I bring up Blanca Torres because I and several other senators who knew her have introduced a resolution to honor her memory and the contributions she made to our state. I hope our resolution will also serve to introduce Blanca Torres to senators who did not have the pleasure of meeting her and working with her. Let me now switch gears here and talk for a moment about the Senate operating budget proposal. It is a bipartisan budget. It's not one that the Republicans would have written if they were in control. It's not one that the Democrats would have written if they were in full control. It's a bipartisan budget, meaning both sides had input, and this, I believe, is what our citizens really want, working together. And this budget is the first one in a long time that lives within the Senate's, or within the state's means. It reduces spending in many areas, and that's appropriate considering the financial situation the state is in. But education is not one of those areas, contrary to what you may hear. Overall, the Senate budget would increase the state's investment in K-12 education by almost $400 million compared to the biennium we are now in. The Senate package also includes many sensible policy reforms. One would lower the state's government's debt limit. The less debt the state carries, the less it has to pay off. And right now, we're approaching $1 billion a biennium to pay off the state debt. Another reform would end the cash grant as part of the state's entitlement, commonly known as General Assistant Unemployable. That entitlement has been one of the fastest growing areas of the budget. The Senate package includes a bill that would make it tougher to defraud public assistance programs by misusing the Quest EBT cards. These cards have been issued to people instead of food stamps, and we've found that they've been used in casinos, tattoo parlors, other places that they shouldn't be used. And in my opinion, the individual that ran that program in DSH should be fired. He knew what was happening, and yet they would reissue those cards with a full amount of money after they said they were lost, and they would start all over again during the months. And so they were being sold on the internet and sold in other places. It also assumes the passage of a bill that lowered the cost of the state's worker compensation program by allowing injured workers to voluntarily settle their claims. There's a lot more in the budget, but there are some of the high points. Now the process of negotiating with the House begins. I'm still thinking we have to come back in a special session to get everything wrapped up, but we'll see what sort of progress the next 10 days brings. Last week we had demonstrations in the legislative building. They were yelling about closing the tax loopholes. Four of the loopholes they describe are corporate jets, cosmetic surgery, coal burning, and out-of-state banks. Senate Bill 5816 would impose a new tax on the first two and eliminate existing incentives on the last two. These four loopholes, as they call them, would amount to about $120 million. And it's a good sound bite, but only counts for about 2% of our budget problem. Two of the biggest tax loopholes is a sales tax exemption on food, and that amounts to $1.7 billion. The exemption for prescription drugs amounts to about $650 million. I'm certain these won't be repealed, but I use them as an example of a couple of important tax exemptions or tax loopholes that benefit us all. Lastly, we have a Citizens Commission that looks at and evaluates all of the tax exemptions. If you have any questions or comments to share, please call, send an email, or write a letter. I welcome your ideas and opinions, and I'm always glad to hear from you. Remember, you can read all of my statements and press releases, watch my video updates, and keep track of sponsored legislation by visiting my website. That's all the time for this week. Thank you for the honor of serving you. I'm Senator Jim Honeyford. See you next week.